Hi everyone, my name is Lindsay Wright. I'm Executive Director of Therapies and Advancement at Opportunities for Positive Growth. We provide services to people with intellectual and developmental disabilities across the lifespan. Our offices are located in central and northern Indiana across three clinic spaces. We provide person-centered supports, and that is really the foundation and our philosophy on services and supports. We were the first company to attain the full four-year top accreditation from the Council on Quality and Leadership in the world. That accreditation is called the Person-Centered Excellence with Distinction Accreditation. And this is awarded to companies who are very much focused on choice, rights, and dignity for the people that they support, and tailor those services to that specific person, and not just what we assume they need, but what they have asked to work on. We want them to attain what a rewarding life means to them, you know, not what we think of as would be rewarding for us. We do provide internships to around seven interns per year at three different clinic spaces: in Fishers, Indiana, which is an Indianapolis suburb, Lafayette, Indiana, and Marion, Indiana, at Carey Services, which is one of our community partners. Our internship is also 40 hours a week for about 6 months, or the amount of time that you need to get your total 1,200 hours. So we tailor that to your specific needs. If you have a job or you have a schedule that is such that you're not able to make 40 hours a week work, we can work with you and be more flexible. So we've provided 30 hour per week internships. We've provided 20 hour per week internships. We really try to, again, be person-centered. So it's no different than tailoring our services. We would also tailor the internship to you and your needs. Internships start every 3 months in January, April, July, and October. We have a two supervisor model for our internship that utilizes a primary supervisor most of the time, but a secondary supervisor that would be with you around 1 day per week. This is because we feel it's important for you to determine and create your own style of music therapy rather than just mirroring another person's style. That style should be based on your strengths, your personality, and the setting that you hope to work in the future. We are providers of Medicaid waiver services in Indiana, and this means that we have to have an MTBC in the room at all times when providing music therapy. Therefore, you can expect your supervisor, primary or secondary, to be with you in each session. They will attempt to gradually fade into the wall and hopefully give you that independent experience, but they're also there to give you constant feedback and to jump in when necessary. You can expect to get experience in a lot of different areas through our internship. First, you will work on your music skills, and we'll have functional music skills in all of the competency areas by the end of your internship with a vast repertoire. Because we work with people of all ages and all ability levels, and we use preferred music, you'll find that your repertoire is vast through many genres, age groups, etc. We also provide updates to our treatment teams and to Medicaid every 90 days. You will get experience writing those quarterly summaries, as well as attending the individual support teams or the treatment teams. So you will be able to report on music therapy to the case manager, the family, the rec therapist, the behaviorist, anybody who might be on that support team. You'll also take data in every session because we need to report on that progress and we need to show Medicaid a graph of our progress. You will help to write those service notes and take data in every session that you lead. As well, you will get experience with assessments and facilitating a couple different types of assessments, and then writing the treatment plan to go with that assessment. For more information, contact me at the email on the screen, and I can send you our fact sheet and our application. You can also go to our company website, which is also on the screen, to learn more about our company and our internship, as well as apply electronically for the internship. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Anna Womhoff, and I'm the Clinical Internship Director here at Hillcroft Services in Muncie, Indiana, and I wanted to share with you a little bit about our program. First things first, where is Muncie? That's a great question. We are located in North Central Indiana, considered a college town. We have community partnerships with Ball State. They have a large presence within our community. We have easy access to a lot of larger surrounding cities, including Fort Wayne, Indianapolis, Chicago, Columbus, and Cincinnati. All are within driving distance from Muncie. Something that sets Hillcroft Services apart from some of the other agencies and facilities within our kind of area is that we really all abide to our core values, that we're all gardeners. We all strive to be devoted, supportive, and positive, whether that's clients, staff, or therapists. Everybody kind of adheres to these purposes. The populations that we see at our facility include children, adolescents, and adults, so individuals of all ages. Most of the people that we do serve have intellectual or developmental disabilities with some mental health diagnosis. We're reimbursed by the Indiana Medicaid waiver system. We do have a few private pay clients, which is pretty rare. And we see individuals in one-to-one and group sessions. So we have a lot of variety. We do a little bit of everything, which makes things fun and different all of the time. As previously alluded to, our clients are the core of what we do. We work with all ages, interests, ability levels, you name it. Our clients participate in a variety of programming, whether that's therapy services, work services, residential services. Our clients live in a variety of settings. We have individuals who live with their families. We have individuals who live on their own in an apartment, in a house. We have waiver homes with clients living with maybe two or three housemates. And we have some group home settings as well. Individuals living maybe with like five or six other people. We really strive to provide a lot of access to community integration opportunities, whether that's through music specifically or as music therapists supporting other programs. We really, really strive toward independence for our clients, helping them to live their best life and really advocate for themselves. We have a team of six therapists, six full-time therapists, four of which our current internship supervisors. Interns have the opportunity to work with all of our therapists, which is really neat because we have a variety of backgrounds and interests as well. A little bit about our facility. We have a brand new building. We house all of our services here, including behavior management, day programming, and other community services. Our day program is called Creativity Unlimited. We refer to it as CU. Our CHEO program, which has staff taking clients out into the community, and then PAC services, where staff goes into a client home to help them with sort of their daily routine type stuff. We have music therapy, of course. Pre-vocational services and a sheltered workshop, recreational therapy, residential services, including group home, waiver home, and then some drop-in respite services. We provide transportation, and then we also have additional administrative services here as well, human resource marketing, and then some maintenance. A little bit of an overview of our clinical spaces and session rooms. Most of our services here are facility-based, so they take place at our building. We have three small individual rooms we use for sessions. We have three medium-sized group rooms for individual sessions or maybe some dyads or small groups, and then a large group room with some storage. We have some really large groups, we call them our open groups, that take place in our Creativity Unlimited sort of shared space. Currently, we're doing a little bit of telehealth this past year. Not sure how long we're going to be able to do that, but that is an option we've been able to provide to some of our clients and their families. Hillcroft also has an ABA clinic that we provide some services at as well. As touched on before, we really strive to integrate a lot of our individuals into the community. We have some partnerships with Muncie Civic Theater and Ball State that I'll touch on a little bit later. So as previously mentioned, some of our community partners include Ball State and the United Sound program that they offer, Muncie Civic Theater, and then the Barrier Free Theater program. We've had some neat opportunities with the Henry County Museum, the Orchid Greenhouse Holiday in Bloom event. We've had some of our clients go and participate in a few groups and perform for that. And then some Christmas caroling with the Salvation Army. That's always a really fun time and a really great way for our clients to give back to the community each year. Some of the events that our department organizes or assists, kind of co-treats and supports other departments include our big disability awareness concert in March. We put on an annual talent show in the fall. We collaborate and do a trunk or treat, our Thanksgiving dinner. We have various events throughout our homecoming and spirit week in the fall. As previously mentioned, collaboration with Barrier Free Theater through the Muncie Civic Program and then United Sound at Ball State. And then bell ringing for the Salvation Army. And then we always are having different kind of facility concerts and themed events that like pop up throughout the year as well. So in some of our individual sessions, we have a pretty similar structure. A lot of the interventions, you know, you might see if you came here include hello song, a goodbye song, sort of like a check-in or ritual type thing. Work on functional adaptive instrument playing, some therapeutic singing, whether that's through just singing familiar songs, song stories, song folders, using original or adapted based music games, lyric analysis and songwriting. Some of our individuals are interested in adaptive lessons and learning some musical concepts. So that's piano, guitar, band instruments, you know, jam sessions, things like that. We've worked on a few memory projects with some of our older adults, sensory-based interventions, movement, including yoga, dance, structured movement, unstructured movement. We've had a lot of interest in relaxation, mindfulness, some PMR, some progressive muscle relaxation, specifically music listening interventions, and then exploration of digital platforms like GarageBand, Audacity, MIDI, and things like that as well. Some of the groups that we offer include relaxation and mindfulness, music and games. We have a variety of movement groups, movement and music. We have a flash mob group, an adaptive color guard that meets weekly. We have a couple of vocal ensembles, a sign choir and then an adaptive choir. A few men's and women's specific groups. We have a group of older gentlemen who get together and exercise weekly. We have a young guys group and then a variety of ladies groups. We have some instrumental ensembles, including a hand chimes groups, an orf ensemble, a drum group. We have a really popular group on Friday we call Friday Fun. That's just kind of a jam, a fun way to end the week. But really the sky's the limit. If our clients come to us and they ask us about starting something or, you know, present something to us, we'll usually find a way to make it work. So some of the nitty-gritty stuff, internship hours, approximately 40 hours per week, typically 9 to 5, depending upon the therapist caseloads and events, some evening and weekend commitments, depending on the time of the year and what's going on, roughly 32 hours of clinical experience. So in sessions, working with clients, about 8 hours of administrative work. Our internship is 6 months with a total of 1,040 internship hours. This fluctuates a little bit just with pre-internship hours that maybe a student comes with from practicum, but this is usually determined by their university faculty. So an intern's caseload, they can expect to plan and lead approximately 20 sessions per week. We have an outline, a formal outline in our monthly objectives. This includes 8 group sessions, 8 individual sessions, and then is open to co-treatment opportunities with other music therapists, music therapy interns, and other therapeutic domains like behavior management and recreational therapy. Interns will continue to observe and support in additional sessions led by supervising therapists. And then we have plenty of opportunities for leading independently as well. Interns have a variety of responsibilities when it comes to documentation. We have our interns write our session notes, about 3 to 6 sentences, pretty brief and concise. For the sessions that they lead and some of the sessions that they observe as well. This is for group and individual sessions. We ask our interns to document changes in client behavior, whether that's positive or negative. And then we also note client absences as well, so that we can track data. Our interns are responsible to write monthly quarterly reports for like 3 to 5 clients on their caseload. Interns will have practice writing clinical goals and objectives, and then assessments for about 4 clients that are on their caseload as assigned throughout their 6 months that they're here. Just a quick overview of some of the assignments and things that an intern would expect if they were at our facility. Obviously, sessions, individual sessions, group sessions, whether that's big groups, small groups, and co-treatment opportunities. All of our interns compile a toolbox binder throughout their internship that includes music, intervention ideas and session plans, visual supports, anything they've used, we encourage them to put in there that they can take with them and use during their career. We have a variety of selected readings. Some of those are scholarly articles, research-based books, biographies, anything like that. Our interns participate in a variety of self-reflective interventions, including video reflections and self-evaluations. As talked about before, documentation, so the quarterly reports, assessments, session notes. Some of the administrative duties include session planning, establishing personal goals. We have a budget project, a case study, and interns put together a program proposal. And then any additional supplemental assignments that we feel would benefit the intern and help them to grow. Our interns participate in weekly individual supervision as well as group supervision, which happens on two different days. We have a group supervision that discusses a variety of intern-related topics, and then one that focuses on all sort of music skills. At the end of our internship, our students put together a self-regulated learning project about any interests that they have and then present it to our team, to our department. Some of the requirements for consideration include demonstration of functional use of guitar and piano using 1, 4, and 5 chords in a variety of keys, accompanying oneself through the song on each instrument while singing in tune, demonstrating the functional use of percussion, including maintaining a steady beat, highly recommended by faculty members or clinical supervisors through recommendation letters, positive interactions with those around them, and then also showing a vested interest in pursuing a career in music therapy, specifically working with this population. Our interview process includes 2 rounds. Our first round, after we've received your application, is either on Zoom or phone. That way we can really see if you would be a good fit for our facility. And if we do feel like you would be a great fit, we'll invite you to our facility to interview here with our team of therapists. You'll have the opportunity to meet some of the clients and some of the people we work with and demonstrate your musicianship skills. And the other thing that we feel is really important too is an opportunity to see the community and see Muncie and make that determination if it really will be a good fit for the intern as well. A few additional notes, just some things to consider. We do have an orientation process that all of our interns participate in. This includes positive behavior support training, some CPR and first aid, aggression management trainings, and other virtual trainings as assigned, all count toward your total internship hours. Our facility, our HR department requires a TB test, a drug screening, and a background check. All are at no cost to the intern and are conducted on-site. So the TB test and the drug screening usually occur during the intern's first week, and then the background check is completed virtually by our HR department prior to the intern start date. If you would like more information, you can go to our website, hillcroft.org, to see about all of the programs that we have and about any of the news and events. Look at our mission statement, take a tour of our new building, all kinds of cool stuff there. And then, of course, if you have any additional questions specifically about our internship program, you can contact me, Anna Womhoff, at awomhoff@hillcroft.org. And I would be happy to provide you with a copy of our application as well. Thank you and good luck with your internship search.
Did you remember to learn all the songs like hello and goodbye, sing them all day long while meeting with supervisors, downloading all the apps while observing all day long with no time for naps, go to meet clients, make your schedule, and do community observations. Hi, 6 months in duration. Hi, located in North Dallas. Hi, with 9 music therapists. Ba-do-do, 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 reading the MTAP, and don't forget the SEMTAP. Select a client for case study and 5 different presentations. Now in month 4, we turn up the hype. Your senior intern leading sessions all of the time. Special project. Yeah, it's time to launch away. supervision, aye. Monthly team meetings, aye. You're a part of the team. Aye. Write about your case study, aye. Present it to the whole team, aye. And study for the CBMT. Next in month 5. You're still working away, writing notes and leading sessions each and every day. Start the job search and create a resume.
Aye, 6 months in duration. Aye, located in North Dallas. Aye, with 9 music therapists.
Sound Starts Music Therapy. Apply online today. Sound Starts Music Therapy. We sing all day. Sound Starts Music Therapy. Apply online today. Sound Starts Music Therapy. We sing all day.